And here I'm going to walk you through just how easy it is to secure your Google account using a hardware key. So anytime you're just going to come up here on any Google page to your name. In my case, it's my test account. So we're going to go manage my account. Over here on the left, we are going to select security. And then right here in the middle, you can see sign into Google. You've got password, last changed on January 4th. You can use your phone as a second factor, which isn't terrible. I mean, if you're going to try and do anything, SMS is better than nothing. But we are here because we're going to do two-step verification. We're going to click on that. And as you can see, it's saying you're going to add an extra layer, enter your password and a unique code, keep the bad guys out. So we're going to say get started. And it's going to require you to put in your password again. So we're just going to pause for a second. And you may notice that I have this little icon here. That's because I use a password manager. So if you've got a lot of passwords, I highly suggest checking out a password manager. They're kind of hard to do reviews on because there's just so much sensitive information. But once you put your password in, all right. So by default, it was making me use a phone number because I provided a phone number. Once I provided the phone number, here you could see, you can set up an alternative, which is what we want to do. We could do a backup code, which just prints stuff off. We can use Google Prompt. We can use an authenticator app like Authy or Google Authenticator. Backup phone number. We want this one down here. Security key. So we're going to say add a security key. So you're going to make sure your key is with you next to your computer. You're going to hit yes. And what it's going to do is it's saying, hey, plug it into the computer. In my case, here is my authentication key. And in my case, here is my authentication key, which I will just be putting into the USB port on my computer, like so. You can see it's flashing there. You see on screen, setting up Yubikey device. It continues to flash there. On screen, once you've connected, you're just going to touch it, and it proves that you're there. And that's all there was to it. Now, up top here, where it has my phone number, which I don't want to show, it shows the YubiKey. We can edit it, which I will scroll up and pause. Clicking the little edit button next to it allows you to give the security key a name. So in my case, I will call it, and then I can hit done. Likewise, there is the option of if you have more than one key that you want to use, you can, in that edit box, just select add another key, and you can, well, add another key. In my case, as I talked about before, I like having everything in threes, so I will go through and at the very least add my second key that I normally keep, and we're just going to go and hit next. And here we go. Just like before, we've got our YubiKey. We're going to stick it into the port. It starts flashing. Computer is recognizing what it is, and all we have to do is touch that, and what you're not seeing on screen is Chrome is saying, do I want to allow this to access my account? I say allow, and it adds it to the account. And we will call this YubiKey Blue NFC, and then hit OK. And then I will have two keys attached to this account. So this is what happens next when you log back in to your account. I put in my username and password. I'm going to hit next. And it's going to ask me to do something. You can see it up there at the top. All I have to do is put in one of those YubiKeys, which I will do right now. Just like we did when we were setting it up, put it in, it flashes, I touch it. And then boom, it is verified. Now I can choose not to ask me again on this computer. This is my personal computer, but it is a laptop, so it does travel with me. So I will just say, nope, you can ask me every time. And it's as simple as that. Just doing that adds a second layer of authentication, which is infinitely more helpful than having nothing.